Hi, my name is Danny Langley, and I'm a solution architect located in Washington, D.C. I work with many of our largest and most complex enterprise customers to help them understand how they can use analytics across their organization to affect change and inspire new ways of thinking. So Qlik is really excited to be in the Gartner BI Bake-Off as we're celebrating our 10th consecutive year rated as a leader in the Gartner Magic Quadrant. You know, if I were watching this presentation today, the big question in my mind would be, so how is Qlik different and would it be a fit for my organization? You know, we've always considered the human being integral to decision making, and this is reflected in the three ways in which Qlik is unique that really sets us apart from our competitors. So our analytics power is not based on SQL that was built in the 1980s for transactional systems, not modern analytics. Qlik, in contrast, is built from the ground up with an in-memory analytics engine, which we call the associative engine. This gives you a truly unique peripheral view as you're analyzing not only the data you see, but the data you don't see, helping you avoid tunnel vision in your analysis common to SQL-based tools only oriented on questions you ask with the data you see. It also provides a foundation for advanced cognitive strategy. You know, Qlik has a fully web-based interface, which provides a modern consumer-grade user experience, touch-first and web browser native. This helps drive user adoption and enables easy integration with customer-facing web portals. In addition, our multi-cloud and open data approach means that our customers have choice and don't need to fear cloud lock-in. Qlik has a unique product vision that takes advantage of our associative engine and pairs it with machine learning and augmented analytics capabilities. The bottom line here is that our software makes it easier for your business users to discover and act upon data insights. You know, while individual users love the unique associative experience, we really shine when it comes to large-scale analytics deployments where you need to drive adoption across large groups of business users in complex organizations. Thanks a lot. I'm in Qlik Sense, and you may notice there's a little green bot at the bottom of the screen. It's becoming a good friend of mine because I can talk to it using common natural language and say things like, tell me about life expectancy. You can see that it's given me an immediate response and was smart enough to show it to me in a logical chart. Just using conversational analytics, I don't have to hunt and peck for the answer in any of our apps. I get it served up to me immediately, just like you experience with Google or Alexa. Okay, now if I want to get deeper into the data, we can open the source application to explore the dashboard. Now from this vantage point, we can see that the main metric we're tracking here is life expectancy. Now what probably jumps out first is that the US is well behind the rest of the countries in our data set, shown by the secondary red KPI, our box plot outliers, and our map view below. In fact, it ranks dead last for these metrics, which our app also points out at the top here. You can see that Qlik is performing natural language generation too, showing us US stats in all these categories. Now, if we want to get a side-by-side comparison with, say, Australia, I can select Australia, and now it's telling me how the US compares with Australia against all these metrics. Hopefully, you notice how all my objects updated. With Qlik, you never have to worry about wiring them together like we do with other tools. Now we can see that although life expectancy has increased for all the other countries over the last several years, the US has remained behind and in fact has dropped recently. The greatest variance between the US and the globe occurs in the last year. Even if we break it down by gender, the US life expectancy for males and for females are worse than the rest of the countries. Now what's interesting is that we can see how much each of the countries spend on healthcare from two different views. And we can see the US actually spends more than all the other countries as shown by the size of the US in this tree map. So clearly there's no correlation between life expectancy and healthcare expenditures in the US, but maybe we want to dig into this further for the other countries. I'm going to move to my next view. Now from here, we built a crosstab analysis and we used a simple built-in correlation function to see how healthcare expenditures related to life expectancy. The red color indicates little to no correlation. What you'll see is no matter which view you take in the crosstab, there doesn't really appear to be a correlation. So we might want to take a broader look at all our indicators at once. Now we can see which indicators seem to correlate highest with life expectancy. Right near the top of the list, we can see mortality from cardiovascular disease, cancer, and diabetes. We can see the strong negative correlation in the scatter plot. You know, by and large, many do point to this to explain the large gap between the US and the rest of the advanced countries. Now, to explain the drop-off in life expectancy the last couple of years, some have mentioned the opioids epidemic in the US. Now we can see the opioids near the top of the list as well. You know, we added it as an additional indicator and ran the correlation against it. So this is probably something worth exploring. Oh yeah, did I mention Qlik is 100% browser-based, which means you can access this dashboard from any device without having to rebuild the mobile-specific version. And if you decide to use a Qlik mobile app, you can be completely offline and get the same full experience. I love Qlik Sense Advisor. It uses AI and machine learning and acts like a dashboard personal assistant you can boss around. I can say things like, show me correlation by indicator and country count. Qlik is going to auto-generate and suggest charts for me to use and rank them based on what it thinks I may be most interested in using. It's not black box AI though, so it gives me multiple options to choose from. If I scroll down below, I can see a correlation table I want to add to my analysis. To add a chart to my dashboard, I simply Qlik Add to Sheet. Now, I'm not done yet. I want to compare mortality from CVD with average life expectancy at birth by country. Now, using a natural language search, you can see Qlik has built me this nice looking scatter plot completely on the fly using AI and its associative engine. To help build trust, Qlik has also deconstructed its logic and shows us exactly how it arrived at its results at the top. I'll go ahead and add the scatter plot to my sheet. Now, when I leave the Insights Advisor, I can see the charts I just added, and maybe I just want to increase their size. I'll go into edit mode to quickly do that. And now what you'll see is that I can actually apply a filter by selecting the US and my other table will update accordingly, again, without having to wire my charts to one another. Now, I'm gonna go ahead and move to the opioid sheet to get some more information here. So from this view, I can now see life expectancy by states, with red states being the worst. I'm gonna go ahead and select Kentucky to go to the county view. Now, clearly the eastern part of the state is in the worst shape, and I know Kentucky has been hit hard by the opioids epidemic, so maybe I want to see where the greatest density of opioids-related deaths have occurred. I'll add this heat map. I can see many deaths have also occurred on the eastern part of the state. I'm going to go ahead and lasso these counties to get some more information on them. I also know this part of Kentucky has been recently hit hard by the COVID crisis and really lacks infrastructure needed to respond effectively. What's nice is my dynamic view has refreshed to pull in real-time COVID-19 rankings and stats for these counties from our snowflake table. County authorities could use this to prioritize response activities given some of their resource constraints. When I go ahead and move to my next view, my filters are going to travel with me, and I can get details on the physicians serving these areas where they're located on the map. From here, I want to see what kind of drugs are being prescribed in this area, so I'm going to go ahead and manually add a chart by going into edit mode. What's really nice is you don't have to create charts on separate sheets and then go through the hassle of combining them all into one dashboard like in other tools. You can do this all in one place. And notice how I can select from a governed list of dimensions and measures, which have already been defined and blessed, giving me confidence that I'm getting accurate and consistent results as I build out my dashboard. So now you can see that on the fly, Qlik was smart enough to know that it would make sense to create a bar chart based on the type of data I'm analyzing. I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to select the top provider. Now, once I select the provider, if I hover over them, I can see what kind of drugs they're prescribing and how much exactly. And I may notice the amount of drugs this provider is prescribing just seems like a lot. So now I want to compare that against the average of all the other prescribers in this geographic area just by choosing to select alternative up here. Now I've pivoted my entire analysis on this head, which would be virtually impossible to do in a query-based tool without additional data modeling and creating specific queries ahead of time. Notice the drugs prescribed by all the other providers is just a fraction of what this physician was prescribing. You know, clearly this is an example where the government could use Qlik to drive policy and regulation when it comes to drug prescriptions. You know, these are findings that I might want to report out on, so I'll use a Qlik story to do so. Now, as a developer or a consumer, I can grab objects from anywhere across my app and build a cohesive dynamic story. It's kind of like an interactive PowerPoint built into the platform. So even if someone questions me about, let's say, the physician's details, what I can do is I can quickly go back to the source with my filters applied and answer any questions here. So you've just seen a natural language search used to build charts on the fly using AI, a dynamic view giving you real-time data results, a governed way to easily build charts on the go, and finally a live interactive way to present findings through Qlik Stories.
So there's a few ways to add data into Qlik. Starting out in our catalog view, which is integrated directly into Qlik, looking at all of our governed data that's been prepared, transformed, and is now available to me as a self-service user. I'll begin by searching for my bake-off data. Now, Qlik has returned two tables, and it's given me scoring information on them to help me decide if I want to add them to my analysis, so I don't have to cross my fingers and hope I'm using the best possible data set. I'm going to go ahead and select these tables and then add them to my app. Now, I want to link these tables, of course. Just by selecting a table, Qlik tells me a likely association can be made through visual indicators. And what you'll see is that Qlik has created this association on country code and year, even though the columns were named differently. Notice I didn't say join, so with Qlik associations, you never have to worry about data getting left behind or double counted, which we all know can lead to incorrect findings like you do when you're using joins. Now, I've got a couple more data sets to add for my local machine, a text file and an Excel file. I've got Windows Explorer pulled up, and I'll simply drag and drop them onto my app. And now I'll use Insight Advisor's Recommended Associations panel to create my final table connections. Now, this isn't the perfect data set. It never is. So I have a few data model changes that I need to make, and I'll do that for my table view. From here, I'm going to go ahead and parse out my location field to create separate county and state fields. So I've created my county field, and here's my state field. And now I'll create some life expectancy buckets. I'll just call them low, medium, and high because I'm feeling super creative today. And in just a couple clicks, I've now got a complete data model. Here you go. No scripting, 4 tables, 3 different data sources. And PS, you can connect to virtually any data source and add as many tables as you want in Qlik without running into issues like you do with query-based tools. So you just click load data now and you're off to the races building a dashboard. So I've begun creating a dashboard, and now I want to use this new field I created in the data manager. I'm going to use my global smart search to see where the low and medium life expectancy counties are in Kentucky. Using the global search, Qlik will scan across all the fields loaded into this app, and just like a Google search, Qlik will be smart enough to know how to rank the hits, and I can see exactly what I'm looking for at the top. Now I'm going to focus my attention on the low life expectancy counties. And you might notice at the top that through Qlik's green, white, and gray color scheme, it's telling me I don't have any counties in Kentucky with high life expectancy rates. And then I can also see the states that don't have counties with low life expectancy rates. And this is all made possible through Qlik's patented associative model and simply can't be done in a query-based tool. Finally, I'm going to go ahead and go into edit mode and use that new life expectancy bucket field to color my scatter plot. Now let's recap what we did. We first used our catalog view to confidently load our governed bake-off data sets. Then Qlik's Insight Advisor helped us create our table associations. And next we used Qlik's Intuitive Data Manager to create custom groupings. And finally, Qlik's Global Search gave us immediate findings using our new custom grouping. Studies have begun looking into the potential impact of COVID on life expectancies around the world. Some have already begun predicting life expectancy decreases, especially for certain demographic groups. Clearly, COVID is something being tracked very closely by state and national officials. As an analyst, I may want to monitor the COVID growth rates in counties, especially those with high hospital bed utilization rates. I'll simply select the alert button, give the alert a name, and what you'll see is we're not in any way limited to what we can create an alert on either. I can select any of these measures, but I'll use a chart on the screen to filter down the measures. I'm going to go ahead and add my measures, and then I'll add county as a drill dimension so I can get an alert for any county that meets my criteria. This way the alert doesn't have to be in just aggregated data. Now here's where things get interesting too. We're not limited to a simple threshold alert. There's a variety of sophisticated options. For example, we can use standard deviation to create an alert, letting us know when a metric experiences high volatility. We'll keep it simple for now, and we'll just get notified when the 3-day rolling growth rate exceeds 5%, and we'll say when the hospital bed utilization is above 50%. I can then decide how often I want to be notified and how I'm going to be notified, either by email or by phone. As soon as our alert is triggered, we'll get notified via email or mobile message. Here we can see we received an email telling us Estill County exceeded a 5% growth rate and has a greater than 50% hospital bed utilization. Individuals like the Surgeon General or groups can be immediately alerted through a message customizable to their needs. They don't need access to Qlik, but if they do have access, they can Qlik on Estill County to go back to the source dashboard with the relevant filters applied, so they can quickly get the specific information they need and take action, like maybe navigating to a COVID-related news feed specific to this county. We just saw how an analyst can easily set up an alert. Sometimes, though, they may need to generate a formal report on the fly. For example, maybe the Surgeon General wants to know how the U.S. compares to these other countries spending a lot in healthcare as well. Once I've selected the countries, I hit the Generate Event Report button, and Qlik is going to send a subset of data to our report distribution solution based on the countries I just selected. Now, the output can be PDF, Excel, PowerPoint, even Pixel Perfect. Now, once the report is downloaded and I open it, what you'll see is I've got a beautiful report that's been custom formatted. And notice how it's only given me information in the countries I've selected. Even the narratives have updated. What's nice is you can also set up an automatic delivery schedule to send out reports just like this that's filtered according to what the recipient needs to see. We even have an online newsstand so I can grab these reports whenever I need them. We won't be going away from Mode 1 reporting anytime soon, but this functionality lets you continue to meet those requirements and deliver modern analytics in one solution. Now you can finally get rid of those clunky legacy systems everyone loves to complain about. Our development team is working to move beyond dashboards by auto-creating personalized metrics-based insights combined with automated actions and business workflow integration. We call this active metrics. So what we're going to do is we're going to start at the hub that you can see here. And for purposes of this demo, we're going to assume I'm a sales manager. Now, when I click on this part of the screen, I'm taken to a space where I'm presented with a series of analytics topics that have been automatically created and personalized by Qlik Insight Advisor. In this case, things like competitive analysis, sales pipeline, and customer intelligence. I can also interact with a shopping list to build out a custom selection of metrics that I might be interested in monitoring. This can be from a range of different data sources, both on-prem and cloud data sources, and is brought together by our unique associative engine and Insight Advisor. Let's look at this auto-generated topic around sales pipeline. So Qlik's Insight Advisor has generated all these metrics, including a breakdown of each metric that you can also see below here. Now, when I click on a metric, our cognitive engine generates further information on the fly, including these more detailed charts. The cognitive engine also generated a natural language description of my metrics by understanding the patterns, the outliers, and the significant attributes of the data set that might be hidden to the human eye. The natural language also updates as you make selections and explore, making it highly interactive and helping the user become more data literate to make decisions that are truly data driven. These auto-generated insights delivered by our unique associative and cognitive engine leverages AI to skip many of the traditional BI and AI workflows. Another important business requirement for customers is ensuring that the pulse of the data beats in sync with the business. Let's say an opportunity just closed in Salesforce. With Qlik Replicate, real-time data changes are combined with Insight Advisor, enabling the records to be pushed all the way through the data supply chain in near real-time to the end user. If I go back to my metrics overview, I can now see an update has occurred, as well as get an indicator showing me the impacts to my metrics since the last refresh. I'm also able to set actions against the data. You know, our vision is that the system can create suggested actions, taking traditional alerting to the next level by automatically creating an actionable workflow process. I can create a custom action, but in this example, the system is suggesting creating a procurement order. I can view information on what this action is going to entail, which in this case will generate a purchase order and send an approval request email. Now, once I set the action, a new workflow is created. In this example action, a new sales order has been placed, which exceeds the current product inventory. The action generates a procurement order and sends an email to the approver, which contains details of the action and a link to approve the procurement order. This link takes me straight into the source system to approve. Now, this type of automated workflow would be extremely powerful in any organization, compressing the time from event to action and ensuring that anyone is able to use data to drive real business actions and achieve meaningful results. The Qlik portfolio enables casual business users to automatically go straight from raw data to actionable insights with only a few clicks.